Hello, we go to a very brief tutorial on how to use CES Cambridge Engineering Selector Edupack 2017. We're gonna do these tasks. We're gonna explore at epoxy at different level 1 and level 2 of the software. You want to create a Young's modulus and density chart and the rest of the tests that we do. The first step is to open CES Edupack 2017. As you can see, when the software opens, the first thing that pops up is the databases. You have different levels of the information provided by the software. Level 1, of course, the simplest one, and then we have more material level 2 and level 3. And if we want to focus only on the elements, then we can use this tab. So I start from level 1, and the first task is to, as you can see here, to explore epoxy. So as you can see in the left hand side, we can browse through different materials. Of course, epoxy we know is a polymer, so I click on the polymer. We have thermoplastic, thermosets, and we have only three types of thermal sets here. Epoxy, so I click on epoxy, and then I have the general description of the epoxy composition and other type of physical and mechanical properties and the rest of the properties of epoxy listed here. So we can use this information. Even we have information about the price of this type of material in general. You know, in general we have many types of epoxies, so this is taking epoxies in general into consideration. If I want to look at the same properties in level 2, what I do, I just go to file, change database, and instead of level 1 I change to level 2. Then I'm introduced to this page. Again, I have all materials. I can explore it from here or from the left hand side. So I click on polymers again, and thermosets similar to what I did here, and I have epoxies. Of course, I'm expecting to see more information, mechanical, thermal, physical information listed here, and here I have compared them in this picture. The right hand side shows the general properties listed for epoxy here based on level 1 information, and the left hand side is based on level 2. Of course, you see more information, more mechanical properties, thermal properties, so on so forth is listed under level 2, and I'm not finished here. Still the list is continuing. The next step, I want to use CES software and list or create the chart of Young's modulus of the different materials in the world versus their density chart. So what I do, I just go to the software and select chart here, click on the chart. I have three options. The first one is the chart. We can make limit, add limit, or select from three of materials. So I click on chart. I'm provided with y-axis option and x-axis option. So if I go back to the task explanation, I have to have Young's modulus, say, in y-axis and density and x-axis. So I go back there, and y-axis I have Young's modulus, so I go all the way down this attribute list and select y modulus. On the x-axis, so I leave it as logarithmic. I can choose other types of format, linear, so on so forth. For the x-axis, I go the attributes and I select density from this alphabetical attribute, and then when I press OK, now I have the list of all these materials. Of course, it's level 1 which are listed here, and I have a chart of Young's modulus versus density. So I created that one, level 1. Of course, if I go to level 2, of course you will see there are more materials. Let's change the database from level 1 to level 2. Do you want to apply it? Yes. And of course there will be more. Maybe it's not very clear in this picture. I can show the family envelopes by clicking on this button. I have family of foams, natural materials, elastomers, polymers. So left click and drag. Ceramics, composites, technical ceramics, metals and alloys. So I can easily select different envelopes of the materials. As you see in this chart in lower left, we have those type of materials that they have a very low Young's modulus, very low density. In the very far right top corner, I have those materials that they have high Young's modulus, high stiffness, and high density. Now let's go back to the task. We want to use box selection for those materials that have Young's modulus bigger than 100 gigapascal and density smaller than 5000 kilogram per meter cube. So what I do, I click on the box selection here, click, and look, it's, of course, I want to have it more than 100. So this is 100 all along this line, and here 5000, so 1000, 2000, 3000, 4000, 5000, so approximately here. So I can say everything inside this material satisfy this condition, the limits that we just defined based on this box selection. And if I want to hide the failed materials, I can click this one and they are all gone. As you can see, the family envelopes is shown here, but they are turned gray, which means they did not pass this limits. So that's one way of adding limits and a step to find our desired material that they have passed certain criteria. Of course, we can look at other properties like price,